Happy Monday. How's everybody doing? I gotta get my chair right. Happy Monday. Can't wait to talk to you tonight. How to turn those no's into yeses. Anybody interested? Anyone interested? Hey, Rachel, how are you? Hi, Jen Keller. Hey, Melissa. Looks like y'all had a great weekend. Hey, Paula, Erica, hello. Happy Monday. Hi, Genesis Boyd, it's getting close for you. I love it. All right, how many of you have ever gotten a no? Like, nope, not interested. Nope, don't want this. Anybody besides me get no's in life? If you've gotten those, give me some hearts. Give me some hearts and some thumbs up. Yay. We all get them. We're still alive. Hi, Amber. Oh, Rachel, you get those? Yeah. Yeah. Hey, Melody. It is so good to see all of y'all on this beautiful Monday. It's gorgeous out here. I hope it is where you're at. I hope this winter weather's over. All right, we're going to get right to it because I've got some really good Ask Pam questions I wanted to go over. And I think there is definitely two parts to this. All right, so Amber says she's gotten a million. I love it, Amber. When you get a million no's, you're a millionaire. Hey, that's a good one to quote. When you get a million no's, you're a millionaire. And it absolutely happens way before that. Hi, Amanda McGee, Amanda Billings. Hello, Sahar. I hope I said your name right. Hey, Virginia Wiegand, when are you coming back down to Sarasota? Hi, Crystal. Hey, Sarah. Okay, we're going to get started. All right, so this is typically what I've noticed over the last 20-some years. I had great training when I was selling IBM computers, too, on the power of a no and how to take a look at it from a different perspective, and that's really how I've always looked at it. No typically means not yet, okay? No could mean a number of things, but for me, what I have found is no typically means not yet. Not yet could be as long as another year, 2 years, it could be 10 years, but what I try to find out is why the no. You know, if somebody has shown an interest and you've kind of gone back and forth, you've gone through the products, you've gone through the compensation plan, you've gone through life, anything that you're doing, and someone says no, I don't leave it at that. I try to find out why. And because I have found that pretty much the first three things that they tell you, the reason no, are not really it. That there's more to it than that. So, no, I just don't have the money. Okay, well, let's say that you had the money, would you join? And just stop talking and let them answer. So, would you have the money? If you had the money, would you join? And then they'll probably go, well, really, it's you know, my spouse doesn't want me to do this. I just don't think he'd believe in it. All right, well, if you had the money and your spouse said yes, would you join? Would you join me? And then if they say, well, you know, I just don't really think I can do it, that's probably really what it is, that they, for some reason, don't feel like they can do it. So then you ask, well, look, I didn't feel like I could do it either. But what I did is I got started. You know, I joined, I got started, and I had a lot of help. And I'm here to help you. And so that's really what I do, is I continue to ask in a very caring, very loving way, very respectful way. And I have found that it's not typically the first thing, the second thing. Sometimes it's not even the third. You have to go and ask again. So let's run through that again. All right. So somebody says, no, this isn't for me. Okay, so what part of this do you feel like is not for you? Because you told me that you really wanted to stay home with your kids. You told me that you would love to work spare time for part time from your phone like I do. You've given me all these indications that you really want to be a part of this. So I'm just a little confused. Could you really give me a little more explanation and just try to get to the heart of it? Because there really is a reason that they just don't feel either confident enough, capable enough, and that no typically can turn right around to a yes if you can find out the real reason. So don't give up so quickly. And then a no could just mean flat out, I'm not interested. I am just, this is not for me. I don't want to have anything to do with it. But hey, there's a lot of you. And if it were you, comment on this. Did you first say no for a while? And if so, how long did you say no? Because I remember in my first opportunity, I said no for months and months and months and months and months. And then finally I said yes. And I've been in the industry for over 20 years. So if a lot of you have said, no, I haven't been interested. I wasn't interested in the beginning, but then something happened. And we talked about this before, something in your life, you went through transition. And through that transition, you became interested. So what I typically do, if I get the no's and I get several of them right there, then I'll ask them, is it okay if I just touch base with you every once in a while? We just, you know, if you'll probably pop in my mind, I'll think about you when I see something, and is it okay if I check back in? And I do that. I ask for permission to do that, and they always say yes. So then I check back in, but then when do you finally just say, okay, enough is enough. They're just not interested. I don't think ever. You know, there was somebody that joined our team after 13 years of no's. And finally she went through transition and she was really looking for something different. So I don't think you ever walk away unless they just give you that hand in the face. They're really adamant, do not ever call me again. I never want to talk about this ever. All right, so have you ever had, what was the worst no you ever had? I want to share mine because I don't think you all will believe that anything like this could ever happen to me, but I've probably had more no's than most of you, and this truly happened. So after I finished, you know, I sold IBM computers for years, came home, I sold to a lot of attorneys. This is when I was living in Virginia, and it was great. I just loved it. I made a lot of friends too with all the people that I sold computers to. So when I started networking, I'm like, wow, I've got this whole list. And so I called this one particular attorney, and I got him right away. He was just so nice in the beginning, you know, hey, we caught up a little bit. Then I said, hey, I've got this incredible opportunity. I thought about you. I thought you might be interested. He blew a gasket. I mean, he blew a gasket so big that he actually threw the phone across the room and broke it. Now, I heard it crash, and then the phone went dead. So I'm like, oh my gosh, did he throw the phone? So I called back and I talked to his secretary. She goes, what were you talking about? I said, did he throw the phone across the room? And she said, yeah, he's so mad. Oh my, he was just so mad that I would even think that he might be interested in network marketing. OMG. I didn't know anybody could get that upset. Now, instead of that crushing me, like a lot of people that would just crush. Instead of that crushing me, that propelled me. That just made me go, I'm doing this. You know, I'm just like, I don't care how many people throw their phone. I'm going to do this, and I'm going to do this big. And you know, about 20 years later, not too long ago, I'm back in my hometown, and I see him. He's out to dinner with his daughter. And, you know, I went over and I said, hey, how you doing? And we caught up a little bit. And I said, you know, remember that time I called you and I asked you if you might be interested in my opportunity and you threw the phone? He tried to deny it, but it didn't work. Finally started laughing. And I said, because of that, I think it made me just want it even more. And I got even, and I became extremely successful at it. So I appreciate the phone throw. And I absolutely meant it. So how can you take those no's and empower yourself? Keep a strong list of the yeses and the no's, because I know when you go through a certain number, and it could be for you because of your beginning in this, you get a lot more no's in the beginning. I still get no's. You get that. It seems like they're stacking up against you. However, they're not against you. You need to embrace them, because you're asking, and that is the biggest thing. Posting is not asking. We're absolutely out there asking. And if we get that no, write it down. You know, some people, they keep a couple of jars, a yes jar and a no jar. And for every no, they put a penny in the jar. For every yes. And when your no penny jar gets huge, you're making money. You're making a tremendous amount of money. Don't be afraid of those. Embrace them. Embrace them. Know that it's a part of the opportunity. And then find out too, am I saying, like, a lot of times when I would get a no, I'd do a beautiful presentation, I thought, or, you know, we would go through several things, and they would say no. I would ask, you know, those three, you know, trying to qualify and get to the point. But then sometimes it was just flat out no. And I would say, is there anything here that I could have done differently? And do you know, a lot of times it was because they didn't feel like they could be me, that I was almost too good at giving the presentation. So once I realized that, I started scaling back on that and started not being so perfect, so to speak, and trying to be more real and trying to be qualify them more up front. Not talk as much about myself, but talk more. Like, if you ask those qualifying questions in the beginning, such as, hey, you know, we're here at the coffee shop, why are we spending an hour together? You know, what? Here we're going to spend about an hour. What are you looking for? And then I write it down. I have a pen and a piece of paper. I put their name at the top, and I'm writing down all the reasons why they're meeting with me. I want to stay home with my kids. I'm just not making enough money at work. We never get time for vacation. I want to bring my husband home too. And these are all the things that they're telling me. I write down. So when that, if that no comes up, I can go back to those and I can say, hey, but I thought you were interested in staying home with your kids. And you mentioned that you really are working way too much and you'd really like to work spare time, part time. And I can offer you that with this opportunity. So ask great qualifying questions. Make sure your presentation is always all about them. Say very, very little about yourself, and you'll watch your business really totally turn around. And I always honor whoever I'm talking to by being on time, respecting their time. And if you're meeting someone, whether it's offline or online, and they don't show up, call them out on it. Call them out. Say, hey, where are you? We're supposed to be on a Zoom together. Hey, why aren't you at the coffee shop? I'm worried about you. What's going on? And I always called them out on it and let them know that I was very, very, very serious about my business. So I'm hoping that helps. I'm hoping that every single one of you that have gotten no's, I know you're still alive because you're on the Zoom with me, and we don't die from them. I just know that the more I get, the more yeses I'll get. It just works hand in hand. Not everybody's ready for this in the beginning. They want to see how you do. Stay in long enough to appreciate all those no's turning into yeses, and you'll be extremely successful. All right, so I'm going to read a couple of your comments. Oh, yes. Melissa Yardley, I just welcomed a new team member this week who said no or ignored me for 4 years, and she's working towards executive. Way to go, Melissa. I love stories like that. Oh, my gosh. Let's take this comment out, because somebody's not being very nice, and we don't like that. We're all good people here. We're all good people raising our families, taking care of each other, and loving our products and our opportunity. So we only want great, nice people on here. Come on, let's be nice to each other. We're all in this together. All of us are in this together. All right, so Jennifer asked a question. Okay, I've been in this business for almost a year. I feel like I've plugged into everything and have followed all the right steps. I believe I have what it takes. I love that. Jennifer, that's the most important part, that you believe in yourself and that you have what it takes. And have literally made an ass out of myself. But I do not have a team. And I feel like I'm back at day one all the time working and just going in circles. All right. Can anyone absolutely relate to Jennifer? Do you feel like in the beginning you were just getting started and a year and you felt like you were plugged into everything, you followed all the right steps, you believe you have what it takes, but you just don't have a team? All right, so Jennifer, we're going to change this up. If you really feel like you are you know, doing what it takes, and believe me, a year is not long. A year is just getting started. I feel like I'm just getting started. I've been in this industry 20 years and I learn more about myself every single day. So what I want you to do is you've got to really get that core why in your heart. I mean, Jennifer, why are you doing this? What do you want out of It Works? How do you want It Works to change your life? Jennifer, you've got to get that so strong in your heart and in your core that when you walk out of here, people can feel it. They can feel that something is different about you. And if you're doing all the right things, Jennifer, it's just the fact that people may sense that your belief level is not quite high enough. And that can happen for a lot of different reasons. Here it could be that you're still thinking, I don't have a team. What am I doing wrong? Jennifer, you're not doing anything wrong. You're not doing anything wrong. Let's get this right by doing one thing, and that is getting our why really, really, really strong. I mean, so strong that when you walk out the door, people ask you, what the heck are you doing? Or when you're talking to people, they can feel it. They can sense it, that you have this really strong desire. And when you work on that more than anything, I want you to get really quiet tonight. I want you to write it out. I want you to believe that you can have it. Believe that you can achieve it. And Jennifer, it will start to happen for you. And I want you to also read from some inspirational books. You know, listen to Jim Rohn on YouTube and get a couple books that will really drive you and motivate you, and understand that this is all coming from within you. There's people out there all over the world that are interested in It Works, and they're coming in. And Jennifer, you want them in your business. So get that belief level up there higher. Get that desire of what you really, really want, and you can turn this around big time. I mean, really big time. Okay. I hope that helped. All right, so this is from Palmer. Love that name. What are your top tips for someone starting over with the business? How do I make the second time successful? Just do it, Palmer. You know, Cammy quit three times and came back. Cammy Dempsey, Pentecost. Yes, yes. We all feel like quitting hundreds of times, and we just don't. Most of us, well, a lot of us do and come back. So don't think of this as a second time around. Just start. Just do what you want to do in this business. Don't feel like you have to explain yourself. Don't feel like you have to explain yourself to anybody. You know, that's part of your story. Your story is, I came in and I quit. I quit because I didn't believe in myself, or I quit because of this. And don't regurgitate it more than a couple of times, because no one really cares. What we care about is that you're in now and that you're working. And so you're better for it. Look, you already know a lot. So go gangbusters. Just go. I'm breaking Emerald in record time. I mean, that's what I would be talking. Hey, this is my second time, my second go around. I don't care if you quit 10 times. You're here. That's what's important, and that you just get started. You've got this. You can do it, Palmer. We know you can. All right. All right. Let's see. I want to go to this one. Then there's a couple more that I can answer. All right. What do you say to them, Pam, when they're always thinking about it? Always thinking about it. Does anybody ever have anybody say, I'm just thinking about it? I'm just thinking about it. Well, ask them, what are you thinking about? What about this do you have to keep thinking about? What is it that you're thinking about? And really pin it down and say, hey, I'm going to write this down, what you're thinking about. And then always come back to, you know, I was thinking about that too when I first started. I thought about that a lot. And then I just got started and it took care of itself. So just call them out on it. Just keep asking. All right, so you think about that. Is there anything else that you're thinking about? And then what you might want to do is say, hey, I've got somebody that is so good at this that I have been working with. I would love to get you on a three-way call. Let's Facebook them now, or let's get on a Zoom together. They thought about it for a long time too, and then they got started and everything started working for them. So just, again, just don't be afraid to ask these questions. Don't be afraid. People are just, you know, a lot of times we even go in somewhere to buy something and we get cold feet. We just do. I don't know why we do that, but we do. We get second thoughts. We start second guessing ourselves. So I would just call them out on it and say, all right, what part of this are you thinking about? And get quiet and let them start answering. And then just keep going with that. Keep asking another question. Keep asking another question. All right. Oh, thank you, Kathy. Kathy wrote in, Kathy Barker, and said, I want you to know the teaching you did on procrastinating has changed me and my biz. That makes me feel really good. I love that. Thank you. And Vivian is from Norway. Oh, I love it, Vivian. She changed her focus from doing this for myself to do it for others, and my business went boom. Yep. And all of you are in agreement. Hey, if any of you have a great book that you feel really inspired you, put it out here and so that Jennifer can see it, because that's what we want to know. We want to know what book really inspired you. You know, my first one of them is The Magic of Thinking Big. I love that book. We need to all think bigger. That is a really, really good book, The Magic of Thinking Bigger. All right, so let me look back at these questions. All right, here's a long one, and then we're going to end with this. Hey, Pam, here's my Ask Pam question. How do keep potential loyal customers or distributors engaged in order to secure the bag? I have several people who have expressed interest in the products or the business, and then after talking with them, explaining in a nutshell about what they're interested, when it comes down to placing the order or signing up, they go radio silent. See, when they read their DMs or on their I see the read time, but it's like I'm being ignored. It's so frustrating, especially when they initiate it reaching out to me. All right, well, just call them out on it. Say, hey, you called me. All right, you text me. So what's going on? What more? You know, I thought you said you wanted to lose this weight, or I thought you said you needed extra money. Now, here's one thing that I would do. I'd pick up the phone. I would either do voice message or call them and talk to them straight up. That's what I would do, because they called you, they expressed interest. Again, a lot of times they're reaching out, and then they might talk to somebody and they go, oh, you don't want to do that. Or even their own spouse, or those products probably don't work. So maybe they just need more information. Maybe they've gone rogue on you for just a day or two. Don't get frustrated. Right now, we have, for the distributors, where they can get the kit for basically half off. Bring a friend in. You get the kit for half off, the same kit that everybody else is paying full price for up until yesterday. Great way to get back to all those distributors, and a great way to get to all those customers that you have as well. And let them know that you are going to offer them this same kit for that, and find a friend to do it with you, because, heck, that's starting out right away, earning those fast start bonuses, making the business profitable for everyone. So make sure that you're using your voice. It's so important sometimes, most of the time, for people to hear our voice instead of just texting and relying on that, because they can't hear the passion that you have and that strong desire that you have. So don't be afraid to reach out in that way. All right, let me see if there's one more, because we've got a little bit more time. All right, for those of you who want more Ask Pam questions, you can go to my page. Make sure you hashtag Ask Pam. I'll answer a few of those next time when we're on here together. And I've just got more surprises for all of you. So let me look back through here. And what about people who seem interested but ignore your messages? We just talked about that. You know, just call them out. Say, hey, girl, why are you ignoring me? What's going on? And just be bold and voice message them. Do whatever it takes. Hi, Evelyn from Germany. Just make sure you're letting them feel your heart and your passion about that. Let them do that. Let them feel that. Hey, Jody. All right, let me look through here and see if there's anything else going on. All right, everybody. We are excited about, My Miracle Morning. Great book. Great book. Love that book. Yes. And you can listen to that too. If you're not a reader, you can listen. You can download through Audible. That's what I use. A lot of books are on YouTube as well, so you can listen to those. The Go Giver, excellent. Read that too. Love that book. All right. So, happy Monday, everybody. I just love being here and being live with all of you. Killing Kryptonite, that's a good book. Chase the Lion, yes. Oh, I haven't read Sun Stand Still. I love Stephen Furtick. I'll read that, Brianna. That sounds like a good one. Yes, let's all just take our businesses to a whole nother level, because we can. The opportunity is there. It's all for the asking. So make sure you're asking big questions. And a big question would be, how do I take my business to a whole nother level? How do I earn $50,000 a month? How do I earn $5,000 a month? Ask those type of questions, those big questions, and then get quiet. And what you're going to hear is, just go get some no's. You're just go ask. Ask and you shall receive. That's my favorite line in the entire Bible. Ask and you shall receive. So some of you are not asking big enough questions. What do you want? Ask that question and then get very quiet and then just take action based off of what you're listening to. So I love you all so much. Mwah! Bye, everyone. Thanks for joining in. See you next week, if not before.